Good evening. Tonight I'd like to talk about a new set of reloading dies that I have purchased. I did own a set of the Lee Alexander Arms 6.5 Grendel dies, but I was having some problems out of the full-length sizer, so I sent those back to Midway USA, no questions asked. They let me trade it in for the Hornady 6.5 Grendel dies. This is the Grendel round, 120 grain A-Max 6.5 millimeter. This is an Alexander Arms Lapua brass 6.5 by 39, the parent case being 762 by 39. As with all new dies, you need to clean the shipping oils and things like that. It's a good rust preventative, but it's not very good lubricant. These Hornady dies, of course, you get 100 free bullets with any Hornady's new zip spindle, custom grade, new dimension dies. Very nice box. You do not get the shell holder with this, but you do get the Allen wrench. Direction books, an extra decapping pin, and an extra lock ring for your cedar, and I'll show you that in just a moment. Your full-length sizing die, I do want to say this, right out of the box I did notice that there is some type of coating, corrosive preventative coating. This is kind of like the Lee full-length sizer die, as there's a collet with the rod through it. The biggest difference is this rod is threaded. You can make minute changes, and it also keeps it from slipping. With Lee's, if you don't have this really, really tight, you can slip that out. This right here is a collet that tightens around it. So in order to clean this, you got to take your dies apart anyways. So go ahead and move this out of the way. Got a lock ring where it tightens from the side instead of going into your threads. I like that. This is your size and body, just like any other sizer from this point on. And then you have their zip spindle. Like I said, you can turn this to adjust the height up and down. Also, since the collet's not tight, you can when it's not tight, you should be able to just slide it off, but that's fine. So the collet is threaded inside and out. The whole rod is threaded. And this part is like the RCBS. The expander ball is threaded. Also, so that you can change out your decapping pin. We'll get that one cleaned here in a moment. Now, you got your bullet seating die. As you can see here, there's a sleeve that falls out. What this sleeve does that other bullet seating dies does not, it offers you a chance to be able to seat your bullet to your case while minimizing run out. If you can think on this just for a moment with any other dies, when you've got it in your press and you put the bullet in, you have just a hollow tube with the seater stem. It's going up into your die, cantered. Then the seating stem gets it and seats it. So you still have the chance of the bullet being cantered, which gives you run out. The acceptable run out is 3/1000. When you get to 4/1000s, 5/1000s, and on up, you don't want that. So what this does, you got your seating stem inside the die, and you got your sleeve. So with your bullet cantered, it enters the sleeve first. It straightens up the bullet. Okay, it hasn't touched the seating die yet. Okay, now it's on the shoulder of the case. The bullet and the mouth are perfectly aligned. When it goes on up in, right there it touches the seater die. It's perfectly in line. The seater will now seat the bullet into the case, minimizing the run out that you can get from another die. And mind you, this die set only costed me $32. So let's take that apart and check out exactly what that sleeve looks like. Again, you got your lock ring. You got your bullet seating adjuster, which you can purchase separately, a micro seating that will fit right on this die and let you seat it perfectly every time. Now with that, you got your lock ring, and you got your washer. You got your bullet seating stem. Now, to get this off, you got a retaining clip that goes around. And this is the most, from my understanding. Okay, so the retaining clip swings up and it comes out the side. And you simply just turn this over and the sleeve comes out. So you've got your hollow die body. And this is your sleeve. So your bullet seater goes on top of the sleeve. And the sleeve, we'll set that in kind of crooked, straightens the bullet up, the shoulder. This goes against your setting knob and it seats it while keeping everything perfectly in line. So that's what the Hornady dies look like, and just a brief overview.